The boil water advisory crisis in First Nations communities across Canada, it sadly involves 20% of First Nations communities that cannot drink their tap water. Provincially, it is 40%, 4 out of 10 First Nations cannot drink their water. What Water First is doing about that, and the area in which we focus, is on education and training. Where we focus is on recruitment of young adults, young Indigenous adults, to the field of water treatment, to the field of environmental water quality monitoring, and we support them to obtain their entry-level certifications and to enter the professional field as young professionals.
The Water First Internship is a 15-month paid program for youth and young adults. They receive training in water treatment and environmental water quality monitoring. They also work in their home community water treatment plants. Working through this internship has taught me the power of meaningful collaboration with Indigenous communities to solve water challenges. So this program was really a teamwork and collaborative effort between our partners at the Tribal Council, the individual community members, the water treatment plant operators, and the interns themselves. Amy Wabus was one of our most enthusiastic interns. She always lit up the room when she came to class for the workshops and really brought everybody up.
During the internship, we tried to blend traditional knowledge from the elders and the Western knowledge that we were teaching. Some of the things that we did were starting our workshop with a smudge ceremony. In the Anishinaabe culture, traditionally speaking, women are the protectors of water. They are the water walkers. The water treatment field itself is generally dominated by men. I was glad to see that during the Water First internship, of the 10 interns that graduated, 4 of them were female. And Amy was one of them, and she's working full-time at water treatment plant in Perch Island.
The most exciting thing about being in the internship was meeting everybody, meeting all the new people, meeting my new bosses, just getting out there and being recognized for this work. A typical day at the plant is I get to the water plant, have a coffee, chit-chat with my boss, and then we're working. I'm going out, I'm checking the low lift, making sure everything's working, the pressure relief valve, and then up from there I'm going to the elevator storage reservoir to make sure the water is safe for everybody to drink through the distribution system. But after that, I come to the plant, I sit in the lab for, I don't know, an hour of my day, an hour and a half, and I'm testing it. I'm making sure the chlorine is enough chlorine and not too little of chlorine. I just want to make sure it's healthy. It's my community. It's where I come from. I take pride in what I do. Getting into this internship, to be honest, I didn't know what I was signing up for. I came in here for a job, and I ended here with a career. My family's set from this. Like, having this for my son and I is the best thing. Before this job, I didn't care where the water came from. I turned that tap on and it was that. As soon as I got this job, and knowing what the operators do behind the scene and they don't really get recognized for it, is the change there. You need to find people that take pride in it and they want to have that for their next generation. That's why I'm doing it, is for my family, for everybody here. You don't have to worry, you'll have this.
The Water First Internship Program over the next 3 to 5 years, the plan is to expand the program to an additional 75 First Nations communities, primarily in Ontario and perhaps to some neighboring provinces. What people can do to support the internship is they can reach out to Water First, they can donate, they can become volunteers, help us work on awareness of the programs that we do, and both among Canadians and among Indigenous communities that we hope to be working even more with. We wouldn't be here today as an organization, and particularly with the internship program, if we didn't have the support of donors.